Yes.
Please, we're going to start again. I know it's a short time for coffee, and sorry for that, but we've got people online too following this call, and so for these people waiting for the start, it's important too for us to try to respect the time. So I know it's not that easy. And Eric has got a word for you.
Yes, I have some other slides before the exercise, but if you want to about the use of the file.
Okay, so merci Dorothée. So there we have sent an Excel file, the Excel file for the case study. You have received it on your emails, online and here, it's ICTP. So if you have a computer right now, you can work here, download the file and play with that file according to the case study here. If you don't have a computer, we have a computer lab just beside this room. You can go there and use the computer. The password and login are on your badge, that's the one you use for the Wi-Fi. So feel free whenever you need to go. It's just next to the amphitheater. I can show you the way if you want.
Okay. I made a correction to the slide. Probably there is this overestimation, but it's kind of is only an exercise. So we can move on to the presentation about some other issues before starting the exercise. I put in my presentation some milestones about the publication about Earth impact assessment of air pollution. In my knowledge, this is the first publication in Europe for the outdoor and traffic-related air pollution assessment by Nino Kunzli and colleagues in 2000. In this article, they introduce the many of the concepts we have discussed in these days, and also the concept of the risk function, the slope of the relationship between air pollution and health outcomes, and you can see there is no threshold, and it, at our knowledge, no threshold is. Defined, and so regarding the discussion before, this is an indication by this work, and the choice of the counterfactual scenario are made considering different level of exposure and the consideration of risk function for increase of 10 microgram per cubic meter of pollution. After this experience, many other experiences of earth impact assessment has been made. The VIAS project that Carla showed, the first day, and in the meantime, the other initiative in Italy, the earth impact of PM10, ozone, other pollutants in the main cities in Italy, with the estimation of the mortality due to pollution, to air pollution. And another aspect that I want to introduce that is related also to the exercise is the burden of disease. The concept that that arises when we have more than one health endpoints, and possibly more than one exposure. So we have to consider different health outcomes and how to bring together in the one number these different information. So the concept of burden of disease, that is the some of the year of life lost, so related to mortality, due to premature mortality. When we say premature mortality, that is a mortality that arises before the expected life, the life expectancy, so the age at the in which the expected life end, and the years lived with disability, that is an indicator related to morbidity, not to mortality, but to other health outcomes related to hospital admission or other situation. This is a general concept of a burden of disease that is related to every situation. When we talk about air pollution or environmental stressor, we focalize on environmental burden of disease, again considering the concept of population attributable fractions. So the not possibly not all population, but population that is exposed to the environmental stressor. This is a slide from our colleague Otto Anninen that is very, very clear for me to understand the concept of DALIS. That is the measure that I think in another letter will be addressed, but is a measure that can that allow us to consider together information about mortality, estimation about mortality, and estimation about morbidity. That is a sum of indicators that are related to the weight of disability and the duration of disability. The weight of disability is often is usually a number that ranges from 0 to 1. 1 is related to death, to mortality. So a case of mortality is a weight equal to 1. And in the other case, in the other situation of not mortality, the concept of year with disability, we have to consider the length, the duration of the health outcome and the weight in terms of gravity. So we can see here in this example that the asthma is a weight that is minor with respect to pneumonia, because pneumonia is a very very bad situation of health, but with a very little duration. So you can think to the area of to the calculation of the area of all these situation, and the calculation is the multiplication by the disability weight by the duration. So this is a way to put together different health outcomes in a unique value. Of course, when we talk about mortality, this the rectangle is cover all the epsilon axis, because the weight is 1. With this approach, there is a very, very useful, a very powerful study made by Otto Anninen and colleagues to calculate environmental burden of disease in Europe, considering 9 risk factors in 6 countries of Europe. This is very, very useful for different reasons. The first is the calculation and the calculation of burden of disease for different environmental stressors that confirm that if we work on PM2.5, we consider a large part of burden of disease due to due to the environmental stressors, but also noise, radon, dioxins, and secondary hand smoke are relevant, have a burden of disease related to environmental stressors. Another reason to consider this study is related to the type of equation that are proposed in this work that consider relative risk information, concentration response function from epidemiological studies as the main, as the gold standard if there is the availability of this this information. So for PM 2.5, for PM 10, for NO2, for other pollutants, this information is available, but not this information is not available for all pollutants such as dioxins on lead or radon. There is no concentration response function suggested by WHO on based on evidences. So this approach provides a useful way to consider also unit risk that are typical of toxicology, typical of risk assessment, and there are considered in a common way to provide a formula to for the calculation of attributable cases, also when we have only the information about unit risk and not relative risk. Okay, your internet connection is stable, but okay. This this was made on these six countries in Europe, and there is an article published on environmental risk perspective, but also a downloadable, very detailed report that you can download from this website. This is the table in the article that show the large amount of stressors that are considered, and you can see in what I said before, you can see that they consider unit risk or relative risk, considering relative risk where available, otherwise unit risk, and to make the calculation. And also there are the references for these values. And I don't have time to go through this approach, but you can see that the first approach that is the attributable fraction is the same that we have used for the exercise. We used for our exercise based on relative risk, so the epidemiological approach. But in the, otherwise, there are other three situations in which we can use again, an epidemiological approach, but with less availability of information about background incidence rate, and to derive attributable cases in case of availability only of unit risk. This is a very, very powerful, very useful approach. They provide information about six countries together, and also for each of the six countries in the slide, I report the situation for Italy. That's almost the same of the six countries, and also they derive the environmental burden of disease in relation to the total burden of disease. And again, you can see that Italy burden of disease due to environmental stress in Italy is about 6%. In Finland, that is the range more from Finland, 3%, to Italy, that is 6%. There are other in the literature calculation of environmental burden of disease. This is a slide from 2012 from, if I remember well, the WHO, in which there is a disentangle the different health outcomes are disentangled in terms of mortality and morbidity. So, considering the DALIS as a unique indicator, and you can see that moving from net outcome to the other, the percentage of environmental fraction is very different. I think that will be a lecture also for economic costs. So this is a very powerful point of discussion in particular for the discussion with the stakeholders. And this was a first slide for a discussion of uncertainty. But I don't think that we have more time to go into this aspect, but only to show the wonderful work from Annin and colleagues also consider the theme of the uncertainty, and they assess a kind of uncertainty in their calculation. This type of uncertainty is related not only to the part of the calculation, so the statistical uncertainty, the model uncertainty, the uncertainty related to availability of data. There are other kinds of uncertainty, but these are related to the quantitative assessment. And you can see, again, that for particulate air pollution, we are in a situation of evidence that is very robust. Okay, now we go back to our example on landfills. We have started yesterday. We move with other through the slide with some explanation, and then I will leave 15-20 minutes to complete the exercise. Yesterday we have considered how to calculate exposed people. To define, if you remember, to retrieve information about the geolocation of the landfills, the EEA database, the EEA raster file for European population to derive population living in the buffer of 4 kilometers around the landfills. Today we will select the relative risk from literature. We calculate attributable case with the formula I showed you before, and we will calculate DALIS, because we will have to calculate more than one health outcomes, and so to give to provide a unique number, final number, we will use DALIS. So this is okay. This is our formula. We have to select the health outcomes and then the relative risk. The background population incidence, we have to retrieve this from Health for All database, and exposed people we have discussed yesterday how to calculate, and I will provide you the calculation of how many people is exposed to different landfills. What about DALIS? DALIS is the calculation of DALIS is provided from starting from attributable cases multiplied by the two factors that for the rectangle that we have seen before in the slide. So the gravity, the weight of the disease, and the duration. I provide in the slide information about weight and duration. These are derived from the Victorian burden of disease. That is a common use database for calculation of DALIS. And you can see in the first number is related to the disability weight, and the second number, if is reported, is the duration. If there is not a second number, the expected duration is one, because we are considering respiratory symptoms that we think that have no duration in time, so we consider one as the length of the duration. We have considered also some health outcome, some birth outcome, and so in this case the duration is equal to expected life expectancy. So at the time of the calculation, the life expectancy was 79.6 years. Annoyance, we will not calculate annoyance in our exercise, but annoyance is from odor, is annoyance from odor that are related, are from the landfill. And it's, it would be a good point because there is no relative risk in the situation, but information derives only from a questionnaire to the people living around the landfill, and the sort of concentration response function is simply the percentage of people that reported annoyance from odors from landfill. So in our study, we consider 5.4, if I remember well, 5.4% of total population as annoyance. So. One.
1 watt?
No, it's yes. It's a good question. It's also a question that has a referee in our work. We have no information, so we consider one related to other situation. This is 1 year, but it's an assumption. We have no information about this. So we. A suggestion of one referee was to consider a kind of 0 point, because we have no. I don't think that the respiratory symptoms, the duration of illness due to respiratory symptoms is 1 year, but we chose this assumption in absence of information. Okay. This, we have already seen this yesterday. Okay, for the background incidence rate, we have used the Health for All database. We have already talked about this. And for the relative risk, we have used the information for HRAP if available. In the case of landfill, we have we made an ad hoc review of evidence because HRAP didn't provide information about relative risk function for landfills for this particular environmental stressor. So we made a review from literature, and we found these four health outcomes to be considered. This is the 5.4 that we said before about annoyance from odor. And in our exercise, we will focus on these two health outcomes. There's lower weight and respiratory disease. There are two main articles that provide these two relative risks, 1.06 and 1.09 from lower weight and respiratory disease. So we will use this information for our exercise. This is again the data we put on the GIS. This is the Health for All database. I think that is an older version. That now there is the newer version that is the slide I showed you before. But if you go through this database, you can retrieve information very detailed. In particular, we calculate background incidence rate for respiratory disease and lower weight. And so you can go into this database, and for each country, and you can obtain this type of information. So I have provided you a simple Excel file with. I think 26 row of for one for each country, with this information already provided in black, that are the country name, the name of the country, the radius. These are information that you don't need, but just for information. The total population living within buffer. That is the result of the analysis I showed you yesterday about with the GIS information of population and the EPRTR registry. The respiratory rate, the background population respiratory disease rate, and the percentage of Rowberg weight on total birds. These two information are provided by the head for database. We have taken for this four. If you see in the Excel file, there is a different value for each country. The rate of birds on total population, again, from head for all database, and the relative risk for the two outcomes, that is 1.09, 1.06, that I showed you before from Richardson. So the Excel file is filled with this information. What is the exercise? Is to complete the red part of the file with the calculation of at the end of the DALIS due to these two health outcomes. And to do this, you have to make some step in the calculation that are the calculation of birds, starting from population and birth rate, the calculation of attributable fraction for respiratory disease, attributable fraction from Robert weight, and the calculation of attributable cases from respiratory disease and Robert weight, and then the calculation of DALIS. So these are the instructions for the exercise. My suggestion is to work, because at the end, when we go on the classroom, at the end I will show the result for Italy, not all. So my suggestion, calculate for Italy and then calculate for each country you want. But the minimum is the calculation for Italy. So work on Italy and another country, go if you want. Create this new column, calculate total birds using information that are on the file. Calculate attributable fraction using relative risk column. There is problem? Huh?
Boris, you wanted to know when we start and when do we go to the room, so you have to give a go. So it's now?
Yes. I have one slide more with okay, you can go to the exercise, and if you want, here there are the formulas, but my suggestion is to try to not to look at the formula and try to write the formula for yourself, but if you need, here there is the solution in terms of formulas, and so you can go to do the exercise.
How long do they have? Back at what time?
20 minutes, or okay. 15 minutes, 20 minutes.
Okay, so 35. Yeah, I know, but I'm just sitting here. 35, at 35.
This one is better.
Maybe a little bit more. I mean, it takes some time to reach the room, find a computer.
40, okay, 45.
Let's say 15.
Yeah, but 15.
Huh?
On the mic, please just.
Let's say at least half an hour. I mean, you need some time to read.
45, great.
You think you need the formula or not? Yes. Okay.
Oh, if you need to go to the computer room, meet me at the top of the amphitheater and let's go hack this LSIMP.
Work together is possible. Okay?
Yeah, you have it on the
No.
Però insomma bene, no? Sei contento? Senti, a che ora ce l'hai il treno? Ne mangiamo pure tanto oggi a luna. Mangiamo e te ne vai, che mica devi andare alla stazione prima. No, se mi serve capire, con Moovit ogni quanto passano gli autobus qua davanti. In modo che se no sono altri 15 euro.
No, bisogna andare là nella. HIA, the only Excel file, I think.
Giorni su qualsiasi folder nuovo che andiamo a creare. Ecco, bravo. Però non volevo disturbare loro, puoi mettere lo switch al video così loro continuano a vedere.
Loro dobbiamo fare dopo. Continuano a vedere questo.
Ah, perfetto. Perfetto. Perché se no stanno facendo l'esercizio, se non hanno le formule non lo possono fare. E no, vedi, stanno vedendo tutto. Non vedono le formule. Vabbè, lo facciamo dopo?
Sì, no, vedono.
E no, guarda.
No, ma vedono una cartella verde.
Quella come tanto è veloce, dai. Perfetto.
Non le slide, però.
No, vabbè, anche se c'è altro materiale, vabbè, lo stesso, mi importa. Poi lo pulisco io. No, I mean just to have a look, just to have a look, because it's not annoying.
Expected to open with okay, the number of
okay.
That is the population. It's clear in the variable here, yes. The first column to the calculation of births is related to a total population multiplied by birth rate. There is a label that is expected births, but it's the number of births. Okay.
Yes, this is referring to the EXP column. Okay, EXP LBW. That's what professor was mentioning.
Per far vedere un po', per condividerlo è un po' complesso.
Cioè io però ho bisogno ancora di
devo scegliere quale dei due.
Ok,
posso fare così, così, così adesso vedono questo.
No, però adesso fai il torno sulla slide,
torno sull'altro.
Se io mentre pago voglio andare là devo chiamarti.
Cosa devo fare? Qua sopra, senza questo. Share.
Ok, e poi la seleziono.
E poi seleziono questo. Okay. E share screen.
Ok, perfetto.
Thank you.
Are you ready, guys? Do you need more time? Okay, it's 5 minutes. At 12, we'll...
We can start?
Thank you. passata. Cioè, io sono proprio rimasta male dai gambe, ma io no, Casetto no, non mi interessa. Infatti io non ho risposto a Casetto.
Basta che lui ti dica cosa c'è da fare, è così, lui è così.
È un po' impoverito, sai pure, la Pirastum ci sta più. Secondo me la Pirastum, beh, ma sì, ma verso il stile Ricciardi. This is mine, and I...
Ripassare, new share, ok.
And also if now we don't have
I think it's okay. Yeah.
I can start?
Yeah.
Okay. So in 5-10 minutes we go to the solution of the exercise. Before showing the results, again I talk about the sources of this information. The first column of population, because someone asked me to the sources of this data. The population is the population that is exposed to landfill sites. So the population living within 4 kilometers around each landfill for each country. So this is the result of the old work that I showed you yesterday about GIS, the overlapping of the layer of the geocoded landfill and the layer of the EEA population database raster file. The results for each country is the population. The respiratory rate and the birth rate and the percentage of low birth weight are health data, sanitary data, and they are retrieved from the Health for database, selecting each country and going down through the list of health outcomes to derive respiratory rate, birth rate, and so on. The last two values, 1.09, that is a 9% increase of risk and 6% increase of risk for low birth weight, are from the review of the literature we made within this study for health effects of the vicinity, the proximity of living in proximity of landfill sites. So it's okay? Okay. We move on to the exercise. These are the formula that I suggest you to use to make calculation. So, the calculation of the birth rate, someone said that there was a wrong label on the beginning of the column, but it's the formula is correct. We want to know from the total population, the birth rate, the number of births. That is our population for the second health outcome. The attributable fraction for respiratory disease for overweight is relative risk minus 1 divided by the relative risk. So you have to take the relative risk for respiratory overweight. The number, the calculation of attributable cases for respiratory and overweight is the explanation of the formula, the three factors of the formula. So the attributable fraction times respiratory rate or respiratory rate times population. In the second case, the percentage of Robert Way divided by 100, because we have a percentage, multiplied by the population that is in the case of the birth outcome is births. And finally, we have to calculate the DALIs. So the sum of two equation, the attributable cases for, times the weight of the disease times the duration of the disease for respiratory and Robert weight with this coefficient. Huh?
Where are these
from Victorian Bagdanov disease. We use the coefficient for duration and weight from the Victorian Bagdanov disease that is used also by WHO for DALIs. So this is the results for Italy. If you have your calculation and you can check if the final number of DALIs is 1,032, if you This is a calculation for Italy, and then we could have a calculation for others. If I am able, I go to the Excel file that I made. Wow. Okay. And here there are also, there are the formulas. Yeah, I don't know you. Zoom. Where? Okay, here. Okay. I can see the formula. Yes, you can see the formula. You see the formula on the top, in this part? Okay, this explanation of the formulas that in the picture, in the slide, in particular for Dalis is a sum of two different equation. It's okay for all, or someone of you have wrong final results? Okay, well, oh, no, it's impossible. We made it together.
Eva.
Yes, good exercise. And I think we just learned that some of the, or most of the parameters there can be obtained from the Victoria website or something, but clearly this will be for Europe. And we are wondering where else we can get some data for Africa.
Okay. The I have not the complete answer. A partial answer is to check in the WHO website, in the burden of disease, calculation of burden of disease, where are the complete sources for DALIS that they used. Oh. And I think that is the best choice you can do for your weights. It's a good observation.
Yeah, maybe an additional remark is that if you correlate those DALIS with the total population, then you see that, of course, the total population is controlling the final result for the DALIS, because it's an absolute number.
Yes. Yes, following this comment, I have to show that in the whole study we made, the bigger contribute to the DALIS derived from annoyance from odor, because the people exposed to annoyance is a very huge proportion of population. And so, if you can see, if you made the sum of your Excel file, you find at least 13,000, that is the sum of these values, but you can see the number of the annoyance for models that has very low, very little coefficient, duration one, very little coefficient, but a huge amount of population exposed. So at the end of our study, the conclusion are that annoyance is the main factor that provide the number of DALIS.
So, yes. So my question is, we have found that DALIS is about 1,000. For me, what information that I can extract from these values?
Yes.
And second, I would like to normalize the for 1,000 people, not all the 2 million people, only for.
No, 1,000 refer to the number of years lived with disability.
You live with disability.
No, it's not referred to person. It refers to total number of years that population in that country live with disability. Could be 10, 100, 500 person, but it's the sum of the number of years with a problem caused by the pollution due to landfill. This is the explanation of DALIS.
What I mean, this means that over the 3 million people living around that landfill, that those 3 million people, as a mean, 1,000 years will be lived with a certain disability? Is this the interpretation?
In a sense, yes.
I mean, just to understand what what we are giving as results.
And yes, you have to consider also the duration of the life for this 3 million of person, that during the life of this 3 million of person, there are 1,000 of years of the old these years that
okay.
are live with disability due to present offense.
So if, because we were discussing before, I mean, as you showed, for the different countries, we have different dailies. And for countries with very low population around the landfill, the daily seems zero point something.
Yeah.
So it seems that there is no concern in that area. But if we divide those daily for the population, as it was suggested before, then we have similar values. And so we can the question is, does this make a sense?
Absolutely. Yeah, because if you divide it, there are different coefficients that are playing a role here. But considering the respiratory rate, birth rate, similar, the percentage of low births, similar, it's obvious that if you divided the dailies for the population, you have a similar number, because this number could be interpreted as the number for each one of problem due to the presence of landfills, the number that we have to care for each person to the presence of landfill. The problem is, you are close to a landfill or you are not close to a landfill. In a country that the total number of dairy is close to zero, the possibility are true. Or they have no landfills, or they have a good policy to locate landfill in the territory, I think.
So here what the data is. So if we think about Cyprus, the dailies is coming less than one.
And if you?
Cyprus, for the country Cyprus, the dailies calculation is less
Cyprus.
Than one.
Okay.
But while for UK, it is 3,894. So that means UK, if we interpret this data, it means UK is very bad in condition. But if we normalize this, so we find for Cyprus, it is 0.64. If we normalize the daily with total population per 1,000 population, if we convert the data into 1,000 population, so we find Cyprus is 0.64. The next country comes to Bulgaria, so 0.60. So I think this normalization will help us to make the data comparable.
Yes.
So. That is
our
point.
Yeah. In the UK, there is a huge number of landfills.
Yeah, huge numbers.
So a very big number of people exposed. In Cyprus, one or two. one big. There is a consideration. In the EPRTR file, there are stored landfills with a minimum amount of tons. So very little landfills are not reported in the EPRTR. So we discussed yesterday with three landfills in Cyprus, yes, but only one is reported in the EPRTR because it's the biggest one. So, very little population exposed, huge number of population exposed in INGAT, but if you divide the because there is no available information, I think, that can be help us to assess that in different countries the landfills has different health outcomes on population exposed. We have no information to disentangle this aspect.
Is this okay with everybody? The time is running.
Not strictly related to the calculations, but about the interpretation of the results. Okay, We now, we are not going to prove any causal effect related to having a landfill or incinerators in your country or close in the area that you are studying. Mm? For if your hypothesis is that you are not going to this health impact approach, you need an environmental epidemiology. In this exercise, you are providing figures, data, proving the impact using the evidence of the health risk coming from other situations, the concentration response function that you decided to apply, and to estimate the number, if you are calculating the number of cases or the dailies or life year lost, whatever indicators you choose, to calculate the impact, how much, and how much in Bulgaria, how much in UK, so in order to compare them. If no people is resident close to the area, there, generally speaking, there are still an health effect of this plant, because we know that from the literature, but in that case, the impact can be zero, minus than zero, because no one is exposed. So actually, if you have a plant, if you are talking not in air pollution, but if you shift to industrially contaminated sites or waste disposal sites, and no one live there, good, that's the proper place to put that farm, that industry. So please don't take into account that we are not proving the effect of the exposure, but you are just quantifying the number of people affected in order to provide evidence-based decisions to decision-makings. That's what health impact is for.
Yes, and a final point that is interesting for the discussion in these days. This was a study made with colleagues from WHO, so it's an important exercise we made. In condition of not optimal knowledge about concentration response function, exposed people, and kind of exposure. So it's a rough situation, yes. But it was useful to provide information about the impact of landfills. And this information was taken from colleagues of WHO and presented at the last Environmental and Health Ministerial Conference. So is a possible answer to the question, what can I do? Is good to make an health impact assessment without a complete knowledge about the exposure, the health effects, and the population exposure? In a sense, yes, it could be a useful information to give to the stakeholders.
Thank you very much, Andrea. I think it was very useful, this exercise. Thanks for preparing. So our next speaker now this morning is Augustin Collette. He's from Ineris in France, north of Paris. So Augustin is a specialist in modeling air quality in the past, present, and future, I would say. And he will give us a few elements about modeling.